So they asked us to get bags with wheels on them, because they said it's going to be a lot easier in the long run for them to move around. So we went for the Ogio, and this is a motocross bag. We can motocross in as well. So it's got two wheels on the bottom. It's a good, sturdy, strong bag. So that was the choice for us. The Ogio, and it's called a Rig 9800. So we'll have a look at the list. This is the list the school have given, and basically things to bring for skiing. Sun cream. Got some sun cream together, sunglasses, we got him some sunglasses, and ski goggles, we got him ski goggles, we got him a pair of Oakley, and these are the, oh rip, no, I'm not clear, anyway, the Oakley glasses, so obviously they got to go in the pack like that, so you've got your sun cream, your sun goggles, and your ski goggles. What's that card called, Brad? What's that card? EHIC card, which is done off your parents' national insurance number and whatnot. So we've gone for lip balm, hat. We've got hats and wings. Check. You should be helping me with it, boy. Said layers to wear under your ski gear, i.e. base layer. So we've got thermal, but these have to be wickering technology on them, heat generating clothing. So you guys on with it? Yep, so we've got one, two, and we did say three layers. Now we've got this one here. That's a rucksack that he takes it on the slopes to keep drinks in, chocolate, anything he needs to get into work today. That's audio too. Now you can pick this particular bag because you can use it on the motorbike as well. So you've got built-in hydration kit, and it's called the No Drag Mach 3. Looks like a parachute. So I've got to be honest, it is quite a good bag. And then ski socks and normal socks. Ski socks. No, ski socks quicker away the whatever as well, the sweat and nonsense. She got three pairs of ski socks. They actually said three pairs. Then they said that you want a couple of hoodies to wear out in the night. Obviously you want clean underwear. That's a neck tube for some reason or other. Now use the mid layer, these are really light micro fleeces, and it'd be awesome for on the motorbike then as well. Oh, there's the other, what do you call it, base layer. Nice looking base layer top. And then there's another hoodie. That's a quicksilver one, I think that goes with the ski jacket. They didn't tell to pack trunks. Laundry bag, smelly socks, ski boots was a must. That's for walking to the slopes and stuff, going out in the night. All this toiletries, toothbrush, toothpaste, some more socks. What else we got? Other things while you're away, passport, euros, the IC card, mobile phone with credit on it, ensure you pack personal medical requirements. pyjamas. And you'll also may consider a travel pillow. So yeah, we found a travel pillow. Look at that. And got built-in speakers. And it's called Dreamy Teens Speaker Pillow. And basically, just plug your iPod in. That looks quite cool. Right, and they say pack substantial food and money for the journey. There'll be service stops available and on the ferry. And then bring any games, CD, iPods, DVDs, or whatever you need, iPhones for the 24-hour journey. 24 hours. So, on your hour, you're leaving, and you're having 6 nights in Shalalak Sky. Sunglasses and ski goggles, lip salve, hat, gloves, ski suit, layers to wear under your ski suit, so that's your base layer, and you want some mid layers, small rucksack for actually going out on skiing on the days, you want socks and ski socks, then you want passport, euros, your EIT card, mobile phone with credit, ensure you pack personal medication and crap, shoes with grip, so that's snow boots or whatever. Super leisure wear for waking up in evenings. Towel, toiletries, pajamas, travel pillow, and that should be it. So I'm going to keep this in you now, because I'm obviously going to do a final check on the day he goes. So, okay, chap.